Morning, go ahead and start your first line here. You guys here for Mr. Tejada?
Yeah.
Cool. So we're gonna be facing forward, and then can you help me out? Let people know this is the second line. All right, you're gonna be facing forward, guys. Voice tone of zero, one behind the other. Facing forward, thank you guys for following instructions. So my goal for the first day is really to set the tone for what my classroom's gonna be like. So from day one, I want students to understand how we're gonna work, how we're coming in, how we're leaving, what we're planning to do in the classroom. It's really important to set that tone for what the environment will be like.
Okay. So as you're coming in, I'll wait for eyes on the teacher. As you're coming in, you're gonna get an index card that's gonna match up with your seat. You're gonna start off by writing your first and last name on the line side. Instructions are gonna be on the screen. Expectation is you maintain a voice tone of zero.
Giving them instructions from before they even enter the classroom is important, setting the tone in that even the way they wait for me at the door, right, is laid out for them and there's no misunderstanding. I believe that the first 5 minutes of class really dictate how the class goes. If I'm spending the first 5 minutes trying to calm the class, trying to quiet down the class, it's probably gonna go like that for the entirety of the period. So having those first 5 minutes be automatic and calm, there's no questions, the kids already know agenda, Quizette. Those first 5 minutes I can take attendance, I can walk around and check in on students that I noticed were a little bit off. So having that time is crucial to making sure the entire period is well ran and organized and there's a nice flow.
So I'm looking around the room, it looks like 90% of you are about done. Okay, make sure your first and last name is on it. Okay, pencils down, eyes on me. In 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay. Thank you. As I'm looking around, I have 90% of pencils down. I have about 95% of you looking at the teacher.
So in terms of getting over the nerves that first week of school, even as a now seventh-year teacher, I still get a little nervous before the first day. I lose some sleep. I do give myself a little bit of a hype-up speech before my first day, before my first class. I tell myself there's a reason I'm here. There's a reason I'm doing this job. And I try to trace it back to my why. Why did I choose to be a teacher? And for me, giving back to my community and helping build up my community.
And learning intentions. So we're starting on that left side. When I pause, the class reads the next word out loud. So, today I will learn the class. Okay, so that's about 30%, right? Want 100% all together. So again, we're gonna practice, we're gonna get better at this. So, today I will learn the class. It's about 50%, I want 100%. All right, the class procedure for writing my
name.
It's about 85%, we're getting better, okay? So today I will learn the class procedure for writing my name on?
Assignments.
So make sure we're looking at a screen. We're gonna try that one just one more time. That was like 95%. So we're getting better and better. That's how class works, right? That's how life works. We get better at things as we do it. Take out an agenda and a lined piece of paper. Copy down the agenda right away. Got it? Yes? All right, come on in. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. We started off, I think, with the markers. That's what we kind of got to yesterday. We're going to go very slow, just so we get used to the procedure. On Friday, we will have a competition. Class that gets the fastest time, I'll bring a treat for you guys on Monday.
So the procedure for passing out markers is really important in my class because we use markers often. It's a math class. I have these amazing whiteboard tables. I want to make sure I take advantage of them, right? So it's a resource that's available and I want to use them. The reason we spend so much time practicing that procedure and making sure it's perfect is because since I do it often, I want to make sure that we're efficient at it.
Person A, take the table sign off of your tub. Okay, you got 3, 2, 1, and 0. Person A, you're gonna take the lid off. It's got little clamps on there, so take the lid off. Okay, you're taking the lid off, and you're gonna take out the markers. You're gonna take out the markers and the rags. You got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I don't want any confusion. I don't want markers dropped. I don't want to miss. I want everything to just flow. And I give the command, markers out. They come out and boom, they're ready to go. So again, it's all about efficiency with that.
Now I'm not going to do every little step with you. You already know, you already practiced the steps. So I'm going to count down from 15. When I say markers out, we start doing it. When I say markers out, hold on. Markers out, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8.
A lot of the counting down is about creating a sense of urgency. I want to say it's a strategy I pulled from Teach Like a Champion. But counting down creates this sense of urgency with the kids and lets them know, oh, wow, we have this much time to get it done. I have to get it done in that time, right?
Agenda is up on the screen. Make sure you come in at a voice tone of 0 and we copy down the agenda. All right, come on in. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. On your lined piece of paper, you don't have to write down everything I say, all right, but there will be a Kahoot for a competition at the end of this. That's right, so if you hear something that you think might be on there, it's going to be either from what I talk about right now or what I've talked about throughout the week, all right? So you're going to have a little competition at the end of class. Okay. Now, who is Mr. T?
I've shared a little. At the end of the first week, I like to share a little bit about myself so students get an idea of who I am, why I am the way I am, and who is this guy teaching my class? Why is this guy so invested in what we're doing, right? So it helps build those relationships and that trust. It also humanizes me. So I'm not this robot. I'm not up there, you know, some random adult. I have a connection to the community, and I'm invested in what we're doing here.
So as I mentioned, I got two parents, dad and mom. The picture's here. It's from their first time ever going to New York. That was this last weekend. That's the furthest they've ever flown, right? So they were real excited. But that's my mom and dad. They're both from El Salvador, so that's where my family's from. They came here during, there's like a civil war there, so they came here to kind of escape that violence. In terms of what I share, I try not to overshare. There's a limit to what I share. I try to keep it to things that are professional. Even the pictures I share are very, you know, professional. They'll show me with friends, family. So I share a couple of my hobbies and what makes me me. So we're gonna have a little competition. There's gonna be questions on there from this whole week. So some of them will be about the stuff I talked about myself today. Some of it will be about the procedures, some from the expectations, all right? The voice level will be 2. So what's the voice level?
2.
So one of the reasons I did the Kahoot at the end of the week was one, to build, again, the classroom environment is, we're competitive, we're trying, I wanna see effort. So that's the big thing. When we're working in groups, it's not one person carrying the team, it's the group coming through together. The second reason was to check for understanding, see where we're at.
All right, here we go. What's the consequence for being tardy the first time? Okay, so quickly to review, how many minutes?
5.
Good.
It was a great way to review. It wasn't a, you know, I didn't drag it out by giving them a paper test, or I didn't do close reading anymore. It was just about checking for understanding.
So I'm competitive. I like competition. So when we do competitions like that, before we figure out who won it, we're gonna do a little drum roll. Now there's one thing. My signal to stop is go like when I go like this, all right? So let's practice real quick. Drum roll, please. Stop. Perfect, all right? Drum roll, please. All right. And yes. Colombia. Okay, do me the following favor. Colombia, I'll get you your treat. And let's go ahead and clap for Colombia. Yeah.